for the 6 weeks with the 30 countries. So are you all excited for this tour?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, that's yes, great. So fasten your seat belts as we are going to land more very beautiful countries within these 6 weeks. So for today, I am going to introduce with the pilot for the today's flight. So today we have Dr. Nishtha with us. So she is a doctor by profession and passion. She is a basically K-12 biology instructor. She is working with the Bangalore company. So I welcome Dr. Nishtha Jain with us. So she is here to guide you and take you to the tour. So I forward you to the Dr. Nishtha.
Hello everyone. Hello students. How are you?
Good ma'am. Hello. How are you?
I am fine. Thank you. So who all are there? Prakhar and Arhan, Pranjal, Ansh, and who else? Tell me your names. Come on.
Abir.
Okay, Abir.
Mohita.
Sorry, I could not hear that. Who said
Rohita.
That?
Rohita.
Okay, Rohita. All right. Then
Arhan.
Okay, Pranjal. Yes, Arhan and Pranjal. I took your names then. Kushagra. Good evening, Mita. How are you?
I'm fine, ma'am.
Okay, great, great. Who is this? Stuti? Yes, Sudarshan, you're saying something?
How are you, ma'am?
I'm fine, thank you. Who else is there? Sasha D'Souza, Satuti Mahajan. Can everyone please turn on their videos? Yes, sorry.
Stuti is our teammate.
Okay, fine.
Yeah.
All right. So let's first see. Bachu, come on. Let's all focus here now. See, first we'll see the 30 countries, okay, about which we'll be studying. All right. So let's see the countries now first. Yes. So the first country is Australia. So right now we are just seeing the names of the countries which we'll be seeing in the upcoming weeks. All right. So the second one is Austria. Okay, then, okay, who is this? Arika, hi Arika. Is that your name only?
Yes.
Okay, fine. How are you?
I'm fine. How are you?
I'm fine. Thank you. Okay, so now next one is Cambodia. Then Canada, France, Germany, which is the travel destination. So, bachcho, these are the logos, okay? The tourism logos, which are associated with that specific country. All right? So, please see the logos also here. So, this is for Australia. This is for Austria, Cambodia, Canada. Isn't this beautiful? Yes?
Yes,
yes, there's a beautiful flower, right? Okay. Then it's France. Good. Yes, somebody said something. Did somebody say something?
I don't think so, ma'am.
Ma'am, I love France.
Okay. No, never mind. So then this is France. Is everything visible to everyone?
Your screen.
Yes, says, ma'am.
Show me a thumbs up.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
All right. Okay. So let's do one thing. If I'm asking you something, so instead of, you know, saying or speaking every time, just show me your thumbs up, okay? Would that be better? Okay. Yeah. All right. Great. Okay. So now, okay. Fine. Now Germany. Okay. Then Greece is there. Okay, Prakhar. Yeah, I saw you. All right. You can put your thumb down. Okay. Then Hungary. It's not Hungary. Okay. It's Hungary. Don't call it Hungary. Okay. It's wrong. Hungary is when you want to eat something, when you're starving. Okay. Now Iceland. Okay, then Israel, Italy, Kuwait, then what is this? Malaysia. Everyone must be knowing about Malaysia, no? It's a beautiful place.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes,
yes, ma'am.
Okay, okay. It's very beautiful.
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, wow. Okay, okay. That's nice. Then it's Maldives, Mauritius, Mexico, Nepal, New Zealand, Oman, Philippines, Poland. Okay. Then Qatar. It's not Qatar. It's Qatar. Anyway, you can call it Qatar or Qatar, whichever way you are comfortable. Both are okay. Then is Russia, Singapore. It's not Singapore, okay? It's P-O-R-E. All right, bachcho. It's P-O-R-E. It's Por, Singapore. Okay. Then Sri Lanka. So, Switzerland is the next one. UAE. Then UK. That's the United Kingdom. Okay, can anyone tell me the full form of UAE?
United Arab Emirates.
That's great. Okay, okay. Okay, and UK? UK is?
United Kingdom.
Okay, awesome. Very good, very good. Then the USA. What is the full form of USA?
United States of America.
All right, great. Then the Vatican City. So let us begin our journey now. With what? With our own country, India. Okay? So let's start with this. Okay, so what do you all know about India? Can anyone tell me something interesting about India? Arhan, Abir,
India Sanjay. Is a very vast country.
India has Taj Mahal.
Okay, wow, India has Taj Mahal. What else India has? Which are the monuments?
India has seven wonders of the world.
Alright, can you name any places?
India has different languages.
Students,
different religions and festivals.
One by one, please. I'm not being able to hear if everyone is speaking. Okay, so let's start with Abir. Abir, what do you know about India? Come on.
I don't know anything other than wildlife of it.
Other than?
The wildlife of it.
Okay, wow. What do you know about the wildlife?
It has more than 30,000 species.
30,000?
Species of animals and birds.
Okay, that's interesting. Wow, nice. Then who's the next one? Sudarshan. You tell me, Mita. What do you know about India?
India's national animal is tiger. The national bird is peacock. National flower is lotus. National fish is dolphin.
Wow, that's great, 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 great. Pranjal?
Thanks.
Pranjal?
Ma'am, India is the second most populated country and it is the seventh largest country by land area.
Okay, very good, very good. Yeah, bachcho, that's really good. Okay, Rohitha? Your turn.
India is a country where different... India is a...
Yes. Prakhar, is your turn over, beta?
No, ma'am.
Okay, you tell me. I guess there is some issue with Rohitha's connection. So, yeah, you tell me, Prakhar. What do you know about India?
India is the one of the largest democracies in the world. It's one of many secular countries.
Okay.
It is one of the only countries which has a good federal government. India is home to the most number of tigers found anywhere in the world. It's one horned rhinoceros is found in India. It's one of the most uncommon types.
Wow. That's great. Very good. Who else is left? Yes, Indrani, did you say something?
Anj has raised her hand.
Yes. Anj?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, India is one of the oldest country and it has many religions and other things. It has many forts also in the India and it is very popular and historic.
Wow, that's good. All right, who else? Kushagra Sabu, can you hear me?
Dr. Nishtha, there is one comment.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, please.
Ma'am, India is the most cultural country in the world, which has many religions, which is also a great deal in color and all the variants.
All right, that's nice. Yes, Spandana?
There is a comment from Pranjal saying India is a country of religion and has a different types of culture.
All right, Pranjal, that's right. Good. Okay. Yes, Arhan, you raise your hand. Arhan, I can't see you. Yes. You tell me.
I was saying that India has, in the world, India has more religions than any country and all the festivals are also same like that.
Yes, very good.
And languages also go same.
Okay, how many languages are there in India? Approximately, does anyone know? Approximately.
How can I tell about India?
Okay, Arhan, very good. Okay, Arika, your turn, beta.
You tell can me. I talk?
122 languages in India.
Beta, tell me your name. Who's saying?
Mom, see, can raising, I talk, Rohita?
Just a minute. See, raising hand is a good option. Okay, raising hand is a good option. Okay, Rohita. Arika, give me a minute, please. Let's complete with Rohita first. Okay, thank you. Rohita, yes. Tell me.
India is a beautiful country where people of different religions live in harmony.
Okay, that's a beautiful line. Okay, very good, Rohita. Okay, Arika, tell me now.
1 second. You had asked the question, ma'am.
Okay, wait, Prakha, wait. Yes, Arika?
Yes, ma'am. India is known for its festivals and it's a very friendly country.
Okay, wow. Okay, which festivals are you talking about?
Like the Diwali, Holi, Makar Sankranti.
Okay, very good. Okay, we'll be seeing all this much. Yes, sorry. Yes, Arika?
We celebrate all these festivals also. Mm-hmm. Languages like Marathi, like Punjabi celebrate Lohri.
Yes.
Celebrate like that also.
Okay. That's great. Yes, Prakhar, tell me. Come on. What were you saying? Yes, from Prakhar.
Yes, ma'am. Yes. You had asked the number of languages in India, ma'am. It's exactly 22 as of now.
Very good. So everyone's turn is done. Let's start studying. Let's start the two now. Yep. Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay. Let's get on board then. Okay. So now let's see about India in details. Yeah. So this is a map of India. This you already must be knowing, right? You've already seen the map of India. You know the states.
Ma'am.
Right, you know all the states which are present. Okay, so can you tell me, Uttar Pradesh is situated where? What is close to Uttar Pradesh according to the map? Can anyone tell
Bihar.
Me?
Nepal.
Okay.
Member
all Bihar. Right. All right. And what is close to Maharashtra?
Chhattisgarh.
Arabian Sea.
Arabian Sea, all right. Then what else?
Gujarat is also there.
Karnataka.
Gujarat,
Madhya Pradesh,
Rajasthan,
Andhra Pradesh, and Karnataka.
Very good. Okay, now let's see about the location of India. Okay, so India officially the Republic of India. So in Hindi, what do we call it? It's Bharat Ganarajya.
Bharat.
Okay? What is it? Bharat Ganarajya.
Bharat Ganarajya.
Yes, so it is a country in South Asia. It is in the southern part of Asia. All right. It is the second most populous country, as somebody already told me, right, in the starting, that it is the second most populous country, seventh largest country by land area, and the most populous democracy in the world. Can anyone tell me what is meant by democracy?
A democratic country is
a type of government that is for the people, by the people,
and of the people.
Democratic country refers to a country that shares the democratic values of the government, in which the people are responsible for electing their own representatives to run the government for them.
Very good. Very good, Prakha. Very good. That's a good detailed explanation. And who answered the question first? Who answered it?
Ma'am Pranjal.
Pranjal. All right, Pranjal. That's also good. Very good. Okay, so where were we? Yeah, it's bounded by the Indian Ocean on the south, the Arabian Sea on the southwest, and the Bay of Bengal on the southeast. Okay, we have to remember these, all right, the boundaries of India. Then it shares land borders with Pakistan to the west, China, Nepal, and Bhutan to the north. Okay, so let's see this map here again. Where is it sharing the borders with China, Nepal, Pakistan, right? Yes, is it visible
ma'am.
Here in the map?
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
All right. Then, and Bangladesh and Myanmar to the east. So, where is the east? Can you see anywhere Bangladesh?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So, Bangladesh and Myanmar to the east. Very good. Okay. Now, in the Indian Ocean, India is in the vicinity of Sri Lanka. Vicinity means nearby. Okay. It's nearby Sri Lanka. So, we all know, right? This is Sri Lanka. Okay. So, in the Indian Ocean, it is nearby Sri Lanka.
You can see the thread, ma'am, right there. That's part strip.
Yes, very good. Very good, Prakhar. Very good. That's Park Strait. Okay, so what else? It is in the vicinity of Sri Lanka and the Maldives. It's Andaman and Nicobar Islands share a maritime border with Thailand, Myanmar, and Indonesia. Okay, let's move on. Yes, thumbs up.
Yes,
thumbs up.
Ma'am.
Yes, all right. Okay. Now let's see about the flag, the national flag of India, which we call the Tiranga. Okay. It is a horizontal rectangular tricolor of India. Saffron, white, and green. These three colors are there in our national flag. Okay. With the Ashoka Chakra. So this Ashoka Chakra, it has 24 spokes here. If you see these lines here, these are called the spokes. So there are 24 in number. Okay, and with a navy blue color at the center. Yes, clear? Okay, it was adopted in its present form during a meeting of the Constituent Assembly held on 22nd July 1947. So, when was our national flag adopted? Yes,
3 days
when was
it adopted? After, 3 days after in 1947, ma'am. The current date is 19th.
Sorry, I couldn't get you, Prakhar. Please, can you repeat it?
Ma'am, since today is 19th July, 3 days after today's date.
All right. That's a good way to remember, though. Okay. And it became the official flag of the Dominion of India on 15th August 1947. So, when was it adopted, bachcho? 22nd July 1947. And when did it become the official flag? On 15th August 1947. The flag was subsequently retained as that of the Republic of India. Okay, the flag was subsequently retained as that of the Republic of India. In India, the term tricolor almost always refers to the Indian national flag. Okay, tricolor, this word is always, you know, usually related to the national flag only.
Yes,
this
ma'am.
Flag is based on the Swaraj flag, a flag of the Indian National Congress designed by Pingali Venkaya. So there was a previous flag on which this design was adopted. On the basis of that previous flag, this new design was adopted. Okay, we'll move on. Thumbs up. Okay. Okay. 26th January is the Republic Day of India. Yes. Now, and when is the Independence Day, bachcho?
15th August.
Yes, very good, very good. Okay, who are these two personalities? Can someone tell me? Yes, that everyone knows. And who is this?
Jawaharlal Nehru.
All right. Very good. Okay, so this is the currency of India. What is meant by currency?
Currency is the denomination for the monetary value used in a country.
Very good. Prakhar, can you repeat it for everyone, beta?
Currency is the term given to the system of money that is used in the country. That's currency.
All right. Does anyone else also want to say? Somebody else was also saying, right?
Yes.
Who was saying? Yes. Who? Tell me your name.
Ma'am Ansh.
Ansh. Yes, Ansh. Tell me.
The currency is the money for trading to one and another.
Very good. Yes. In the
country.
In the country. Very good. Yes. Did someone say something?
Yes.
Yes, Sudarshan.
Currency means money.
Short and crisp. Okay, even that's good. Okay, fine. So which is the currency which we use in India? It's Indian National Rupee. INR. Yes, INR. Yes. Indian National Rupee. All right. So you already know these notes, right? These notes, these coins, we are already aware of them. Yes?
Yes, ma'am. Currently even having them.
Okay. Great. So now there are some facts about India's economy. So India has a mixed economy. All right. Then half of the workers rely on agriculture. Actually, more than half of the workers, rely on agriculture in India.
Yes, ma'am. Okay? Around 80% of working women in India are agricultural workers.
Yes, good. So the cost of living is lower than in the US. Of course, the cost of living in our country is much, much lower than in the US. Okay, the Indian middle class is bigger than the US middle class. Is this understandable? Can somebody explain me this line?
Ma'am, this means that all the middle class people living in India are greater than the number of middle class people living in US. I believe it means that.
Okay, anyone else?
Ma'am, may I?
Yes, please.
Ma'am, it means the number of the middle class peoples in India is greater than the peoples that live in USA.
All right. Fine. Anyone else wants to try? So Prakhar and Ansh told me. Anyone else? But it's okay. Even if you're wrong, it's fine. It's completely fine. There's no issue with that. But you have to try. You have to be interactive with me.
India is a country which has more number of common people.
Okay, that's a good way to put it. Very good. Chalo, theek hai. The next point is it's an attractive country for outsourcing, such as call centers. Fine. So it's a very good country. It's a very attractive country for the jobs of outsourcing. You might have heard about call centers, customer cares, right? You have heard
of
it?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So they all come under outsourcing. Yes. So they all come under outsourcing jobs. Okay. Now the Bollywood contributes billions to India's GDP. So how is India's GDP? What is it dependent upon? Dependent upon the cigarettes, the tobacco, then the alcohol, and Bollywood is the biggest contributor. Yes?
Yes, ma'am. The total value of the goods that are produced, mainly it comes from Bollywood. I mean, it sucks billions of rupees just from that only.
Yes, that's right. Okay, so here are the heritage sites of India, the World Heritage Sites. See, we'll see them one by one. Ajanta Caves. Okay, just raise your hands, okay, if anyone of you has been to the place which I'm telling about. Okay, just raise your hands. Don't speak, just raise your hands. I'll be seeing you all. Okay, so Ajanta Caves. No one?
Maharashtra. Unfortunately, not, ma'am.
Okay, no problem. That's Maharashtra. Okay. Maharashtra, yes. Then monuments at Hampi. I haven't been there. Anyone has been there? No. Humayun's tomb. Humayun's tomb?
Arhan.
Arhan. Yes?
Yes, ma'am. I had gone.
Where have you gone?
I had gone to that Humayun's tomb and Ajanta cave. Both I have gone.
All right. Okay, what is the meaning of tomb? Can someone tell me?
Ma'am, tomb is the burial site for rulers or emperors mainly after they pass away.
Once what do you call tomb in Hindi? Can anyone tell me what is tomb called in Hindi? Wow. Who told me that?
Arhan.
Arhan, very good. All right.
Thank you, ma'am.
The next one is, Prakhar, your definition was correct. The statement which you told me was correct. I just wanted to know it in Hindi. Who knows it?
Okay? Yes, ma'am.
No problem. All right. Then the Sun Temple at Konark. Okay. Then Manas Wildlife Sanctuary. What's a wildlife sanctuary?
A wildlife sanctuary is an area designated for the preservation of various wildlife species that are currently endangered.
Endangered animals.
We'll do one thing. Whoever wants to speak, please show me your finger or your hand like this, okay? So that even others get a chance to speak, okay? Is that fine?
Wildlife is an area where all the animals stay.
Where all the animals stay. So why do they stay in a wildlife sanctuary? Why not anywhere else?
Because then they'll be safe over there. Humans can't attack.
Yes, very good. They are protected there. So the animals, the wildlife species are protected in the wildlife sanctuaries, in the national parks, in all such places. Okay. The next one is Fatehpur Sikri. Anyone there? Okay, Prakhar has been there. Good. Okay, anyone else?
I have gone to Fatehpur Sikri.
All right. Theek hai. Khajuraho Monuments. No one?
No.
Okay. Buddhist monuments?
Ma'am, I have gone.
Where?
Ma'am, Khajurana monuments.
Who has gone? Tell me your name.
Ansh.
Okay, Ansh has gone. Okay, fine. Then Mahabodhi Temple, Bihar.
Ma'am, I am from Bihar.
Okay, fine. So where was Lord Buddha born?
Lord Buddha born. I'm not really sure about that. We aren't Buddhist. Let me think, ma'am. My father had told me.
Does Nepal? Anyone know? No.
Ma'am, no. I think the place ma'am is Lumbini.
Ma'am, I know.
Yes. Very good. Yes.
There were some gardens. The gardens of Lumbini. What do you call them?
Bodh Gaya. Has anyone heard of Bodh Gaya?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Has anyone been there, Prakhar? Have you been there? Have you been to Bodh Gaya?
No, ma'am. I haven't.
Do visit there once. It's a beautiful place. All right, Bachur. Now, the next one is Agra Fort. It's in Uttar Pradesh.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Then yes, the Chhatrapati Shivaji Terminus. CST. Yes. And the next one is Nalanda.
Nalanda. Right? Nalanda University is also there, ma'am.
Yes.
God, what
Excuse
was that?
Me, ma'am.
Yes, who is it?
Ma'am, I'm Pranjal.
Yes, Pranjal.
Ma'am, I'm saying that the Buddha was not born at Bodh Gaya. The name which he got from there is the Bodh Gaya. Like when he was meditating under that tree, that name was Bodh Gaya. And after meditating there, people start calling him Buddha.
Oh yeah, is that so? Okay, then maybe I'm wrong. All right. Okay. Thank you for updating.
He was born in the Lumbini province, ma'am, as a prince.
Lumbini. Yes, that's right. Thank you, Pranjal, for updating me. Okay, so bacho, if I'm wrong anywhere, please let me know, okay?
Sure, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am.
Am I properly audible to everyone or is there some disturbance?
Ma'am, properly audible.
All right, fine.
Someone is unmuted, which is causing the background effects, ma'am.
Yeah, that's it. Can you all please mute yourself? All of you, please mute yourself. Okay, it's better now. All right. Now let's move on to the monuments. So these are the famous monuments of India. Amar Jawan Jyoti, it's in New Delhi. Then the Raj Ghat, this is also in New Delhi. Shantivan, again in New Delhi. Aurovile Mantra Mandir, it's in Pondicherry. Then Jallianwala Bagh, Amritsar, Punjab. Buddha Stupa, Sarnath, Bihar. Vithal Temple, Vijayanagar, Karnataka. Shaking Minarets, it's in Gujarat. Humayun's Tomb, Delhi. Jahaz Mahal, it's in Mandu, Madhya Pradesh. Then Bibi Ka Maqbara, it's in Aurangabad. And Elephanta Caves, Mumbai. Ajanta Caves, Elephanta Caves are in Mumbai.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, who wants to say what?
Prakhar wants to say something.
Yes, Prakhar.
Elephanta Caves are one of the most peaceful places that you can go to. It's like a soothing effect there.
Yeah, I don't remember. I was too small when I went there. But I'll keep this in mind when I go there. Thank you.
Yes, Arika.
Ma'am, I have visited Elephanta Caves.
Okay, so how was your experience, Arika?
It was very nice and it was on very, very, very top. Actually, we have to walk and go there in the national park.
All right. Okay, so I'll contact you both, okay, when I go there, Prakhar and Arika. All right. Okay, now let's see.
And that we have to cross a river and go from a boat like that.
Yes. This I remember. I remember this. I have gone there when I was too small, but I remember this.
I
have
gone when I was three.
Yeah, okay. Even I was very small. I must have been around 3 or 5 years only. Okay, now let's move on to cultural India. So what can you see in this picture? What is all
pictures
this?
Pictures of Holi.
We can see the pictures
of Holi.
Which are celebrated in India.
Okay.
And regional and international festivals.
And what is this? What is this picture here? Of
Lord
Ganpati.
Ganesh Chaturthi.
Very good. And the festivals of India. So what are the festivals we celebrate in India? The Republic Day.
Diwali.
Yes.
Diwali.
Dashera.
Republic Day.
Besaki.
Independence Day.
I'll tell you one interesting point. These Onam, Besaki, these festivals are celebrated, you know, when? When the crops are harvested.
Harvest festivals. Even Holi and Diwali are harvest festivals.
Very good. Okay. Then Janmashtami. What is Janmashtami?
The birthday of Lord Krishna.
And Durga Puja?
It's done to...
In Navratri.
Ma'am, in Navratri.
Okay, Navratri, Durga Puja. Especially Bengal side, it's celebrated a lot, no?
Yes,
Durga Puja. Yes. Okay, very good. Yes, please.
You know, one festival is coming also. On Bengal. Bakri Eid, celebrated by Muslims.
Yes. Here. See, this is the picture, the second picture. Yes.
Ma'am, on 21st July.
वो ईद कैसे मिलते हैं? How do you do that? By hugging each other, right?
Then by hugging each other.
Yes. And what do you eat? That tasty dish which the Muslims prepare at their home. What is that called?
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am.
Sheer korma.
Yes, sheer korma.
Biryani. Halim.
Biryani also.
Halim.
Okay. Yes. Very good, bachu. It's so nice, you know, talking to you all. It's very nice. It's a lovely experience. All right, now let's move on. The traditional dresses. So we already know the traditional dresses which we wear, right? The Western dresses are, of course, you know, inherited or taken, the idea is taken from the Western countries. But what are our traditional dresses? Suits, kurti, leggings, kurta, pajama, then sari is the best traditional dress, right? Sari.
Yes.
Yes.
All right.
Lehenga, yes, lehenga, choli, sari, then salwar suit. All these are the traditional dresses. Okay. Now, what are the national symbols? Out of these, three were already told by, I guess, Arhan. Who told me in the starting?
Sudarshan.
Sudarshan told me. All right. So, the national emblem of India, the great Ashoka. Okay. Fine. There are three lions here. Yes. Can you see these lions here? Satyamev Jayate is written here.
Yes, yes?
Ma'am, there are four lions, ma'am.
Sorry?
Yes, there are four lions in the national emblem.
Yes, yes. One is there behind.
Ma'am,
there are four lions.
Can I tell you why is those three lions are visible in that national emblem?
Yes, tell me.
One is Chandragupta, second one is Bindusara, and third one is Ashoka.
And the fourth one, which is behind them?
Sushim, I think so.
Sushim, okay. See, I am not aware of this, I'm sorry. But yeah, I would of course search on this and get back to you with this. Yes, Arhan?
Mom, can I tell about the national tree?
Yes, of course you can. Who is it first? Tell me your name. Tell me your name first.
Ma'am, this is Rohita.
Yes, Rohita.
Ma'am, this tree is considered immortal and is integral part of the myths and legends of India.
Yeah, people have even said that, you know, there are ghosts residing on this tree. I don't know why they say that, but there is also a myth about that.
And it's the only tree that produces oxygen 24/7. It's not like normal trees that gives out carbon dioxide in the night.
All right.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am, can I tell you about national fruit?
Yes, please. Okay, tell me.
Ma'am, our national fruit of India is the mango, and it comes at the summer season. And if we eat it, we can prevent many diseases like cancer and many things.
Who's saying this? Very good, Ansh. Okay, so the national flower is lotus, the national bird is peacock, the national flag we already know, the national emblem also we have seen, the national animal is the tiger.
Ma'am?
Yes. Yes, Sarika?
Yes, Abir.
Ma'am, if you see the national emblem, you can see that Ashoka Chakra also over there.
Yes, it's there. You're right.
And ma'am, ma'am, at the left side there is a horse and at the right side there is a bull.
Yes, that's true. Correct. Anything else anyone noticed?
Abir has also raised his hand. Yes, Abir.
But isn't the national tree a banyan tree?
Yes, it is a banyan tree.
Yes.
Ma'am, this is Rohita.
Yes, Rohita, just a minute. Abir, I'm not being able to see you, Vita, properly. Yes, stay like this, okay? I can't see you otherwise. Yes. Rohita, yes, tell me.
The banyan tree represents eternal life.
Oh, yes. So, who told me this? Abir. Okay, great. All right, anything else left in this one? We have seen all of these. Okay, now next, the national anthem. Jana Gana.
Play this on the guitar.
Wow, that's great. Can you make me also learn the same?
And ma'am, I know Jana Gana Mana on keyboard.
Wow, that's
good.
So, everyone remembers it. Everyone has by-hearted this, no? The national anthem? All of you, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
That was 5 years ago.
Yes.
And I know one thing.
Yes, ma'am.
Very good. Very good. I am not asking you to sing it right now because we have to sing it with, you know, due respect. We have to stand in attention position and then sing it. That's why I'm not asking you to sing it. Yes, yes. Who is it?
Ma'am, I'm Pranjal. Ma'am, I'm saying that Rabindranath Tagore has written the national anthem, Janagana Mana.
Okay, okay. Very good. Very good. Okay, now places to visit in the beautiful India. So here are some places. What is all this? Can you all name this? This is the Taj Mahal. See, everyone knows the name.
Himalaya.
Last one. What is going on? One by one. One by one. Don't do this, yeah. One by one. Okay, yes, Arika and then Prakhar and then one by one, okay? Who has raised hand? Just a minute. Arika has raised hand, Ansh has raised hand, Prakhar has raised hand. Okay, one by one, all three of you. Okay, Arika, we'll start with you.
Yes, ma'am. I saw Gateway of India over there.
Okay. Then, what else?
The Himalayas.
Okay. Then.
And the Taj Mahal.
Taj Mahal. All right, Prakhar.
Ma'am, if I'm not wrong, there's some river. Most probably, it should be River Ganga.
I am not very sure of this. Manbir?
It must be Kerala.
It looks like Kerala, yeah? It looks like Kerala, yes. Okay, okay. And then what is this?
Mountain range.
Himalayan mountain range, yeah.
Taj Mahal, Gateway of India, and... This is some
Kashmir
temple.
Also is there.
Taj Mahal, Gateway of India.
Gateway Mountain.
Which mountain? Himalayan Mountain, okay.
That temple. Manbir
and Indani. Can you help us all?
Yes. That temple, I know the name. I'm just forgetting it.
Which temple? Is it Konark?
Ma'am, I know. Ma'am, may I tell?
Yes, please.
Ma'am, it is Bharat Mata Temple.
Bharat Mata Temple?
Ma'am, where is it Kedarnath?
Where is this Bharat Mata Temple?
Ma'am, Haridwar.
Haridwar, okay, yeah, it can be. It can be.
Ma'am,
there is a lot of water present. Achha, okay, then it must be Bharat Mata Temple. Okay, yes, what in Aurangabad?
Yes, ma'am, it's Bharat Mata Temple.
One also Bharat Mata Temple in Aurangabad.
Okay, okay, fine. Chalo, good, yeah, good knowledge. Just a minute. Yes. So, bacho, we already know this. United we stand and divided we fall. What is meant by this line? United we stand, divided we fall.
Ma'am, may I tell Prakhar?
Yes, Prakhar.
Ma'am, may I tell?
This means that, ma'am, together we have better chances of accomplishing any goal that we might want. However, individually, it makes things a little tougher to do. And that's why it said that divided we will fall, but united we can stand.
That's good. Yes, Ansh. Yes, Arahan. Pranjal.
Yes, ma'am. If we stay united, then no one can break us.
Very good, very good. Yes, Pranjal?
Ma'am, if we are together, nobody can break our bond and we can win together. And if we are individual, we cannot do anything and we don't have any support.
Very good, very good. Ansh?
Ma'am, there is second highest mountain is the Himalaya and it has height of 8,848 meters long. And it is second biggest mountain on the earth.
Wow. Thank you for the update. But okay, yes. Kashmir. Yes. Yes, yes. What, Kashmir?
And it is at the Jammu Kashmir.
All right, fine. And ma'am, what do you understand by united we stand, divided we fall? Yes.
Ma'am.
Who is it? Abir. Okay, yes. Arika and Abir. Yes, Arika, Abir.
Ma'am, can you repeat?
About what? Repeat what, beta?
Ma'am, that question.
United we stand, divided we fall. What does that mean?
Ma'am, can I tell one thing about India, ma'am?
Yes, Rohita, wait a minute. Abhi has raised his hand and Arika also. Yes, Abhi.
Do you know our national animal, the tiger, is endangered?
Yes, due to hunting. Yes, of course. That's why there are 51, you know, tiger reserves in India for the protection of our tiger, the national animal.
And I visited the best one out of all.
Yeah, which one?
The Jim Corbett National Park. Wow, I visited.
Wow. Yes, I've been there. It's a beautiful one. Okay, come on. Come back to the topic, bachcho. Come on. Come back to the topic.
Mom, can I tell one thing about India?
No. First, tell me what is the meaning of united we stand, divided we fall. Arika?
Yes, ma'am. United means togetherness. And if we are not together, we will fall. That means united we stand, divided we fall.
All right. So, if I give you an example, if I give you a single stick to break, it's easy to break, right? But if I give you 10 sticks altogether, you won't be able to break them, isn't it? So that's a good example of this.
You'll have to separate.
And there is a story based on this thing.
Yes, yes, of course there is. Okay, so Bachcho, I'm sorry, but the time is up now. So 1 minute. We'll see a beautiful video now, which Manbir ma'am will be showing you all. Okay, so over to you, Manbir.
Thank you, Dr. Nishtha. It was really a great and really wonderful session, and I hope all our guests have really enjoyed. So as for now, like, we have already run up with the time, so sorry for the video. So we'll play it next time. So for tomorrow, we are going to visit Australia. So I hope all our guests have enjoyed our today's tour to the India, and stay excited, and we'll meet tomorrow at the same time, and we'll go to Australia. Till then, everyone, bye-bye, take care, and have a good day.
Yes, Manbir, I have a task for them. Okay.
Yes, I have a task for them that they have to search about this country and come back to us with some new facts and all, okay?
Yes. Okay, kids. All right. So we'll meet tomorrow. Bye, everyone.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye. Thank you, ma'am.